What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo. And in today's video, we are diving into a track that we've heard before from Louis Tomlinson. So this is Louis Tomlinson and Steve Aoki doing Just Hold On. I've only seen the X Factor version of this. So I haven't actually listened to the studio version because typically if I'm listening to Louis Tomlinson, I'm listening to Walls. Until we get LT2, it's Walls all day for me, baby. Before we get into today's video, I just wanted to thank Ryan over on Patreon for requesting this video and being a like huge, longtime supporter. Thank you so much. It means so much to me. Before we get into today's video, I just want to plug my Patreon. I do a lot of exclusive content over there. Basically, my Patreon supporters are the reason I'm able to have a YouTube channel, and I'm very appreciative of you guys. And so because of that, I try to load your Patreon with exclusive posts that you can't see anywhere else. And I did the Away From Home documentary portion of Louis Tomlinson's documentary over on Patreon as a watch party reaction where we watch it, we react. I'm gonna be doing the performances this month. So if you guys wanna check that out, the link is in the description to join Patreon so you don't miss it. I've done so much One Direction content over there. Like, seriously, if you love One Direction or Taylor Swift or 5 Seconds of Summer, you're really going to love Patreon. That's all I'm saying. Okay, I'm ready to dive into this because studio version, live version, very different. I'm excited to give Steve Aoki some of that credit because I think that in the live version, I didn't really like, you don't really get a lot of that from Steve Aoki. I was really focused on Louis. And so I'm really like looking forward to like what that studio production version of this is. You know, Steve Aoki is a cool dude. He's done a lot in his career. He's been through a lot of genres and stuff too. So like, that's a pretty cool collaboration to have. But all that out of the way, let's do it. Wish that you could build a time machine. So you could see the things no one can see. I love this like higher range from him. Oh, hearing him do this like straight up radio pop sound is so interesting. So if you think back to music at this time, 2016, 2017, a lot of the like major radio hits sounded like this. So it totally makes sense to me why he would put this song out. I also am under the impression that his like label or management, whatever it was at the time, kind of like didn't really give him creative control. So to hear him be able to find success in this sound, knowing that it's not his full passion, because obviously we heard Walls, we know. And even then, I think he had a little bit of like discrepancy with the label. So obviously LT2 is going to have even more heart into it. But it, to me, it's just amazing when you're coming off of the fame of One Direction and you're known as this like quote unquote pop star. There's like certain expectations that the people that aren't like diehard fans, but they know of you, kind of have in their music. And so when you have this sound that was so popular at the time and you have Louis Tomlinson, it's so interesting because I don't expect him to be making this sound, but yet at the same time, I think he's nailing it as far as what was popular then. And plus his vocals in that higher range is fucking cool. But it's just interesting to hear him make almost like a dance club anthem. People do not give him enough credit vocally. Oh my God. Again, let's just like play this game with me. Like, it's so cool to hear him do this sound, but it definitely like, it's so interesting to me because it's not what I would expect. And again, having those expectations of artists when they come out of a major group and they go and do solo projects, I feel like that's a dangerous thing because, one, you set up these expectations that are just unrealistic. Like, you know, the music business is kind of harsh. At the same time, you know, we love to box our favorite artists in. Like, even if we love to see them evolve, we love them to be open, but we also love to box them in. So if you think about it from Louis's perspective, he had to be a little bit nervous putting this out because, you know, the last three One Direction albums, he had a major, like, role in writing. And, like, that sound was, like, definitely on the rock inspiration. And then when this comes out, it's not what you're expecting because I know his, like, heavy influence in, like, Britpop and things like that. So, obviously, when Walls comes out, we're hearing this more, like, rock-oriented Britpop sort of thing with a lot of heart and emotion in it. And the thing is, like, I love to be able to appreciate both, right? Because, like, this has its place. It's fucking awesome. But it's just, it was so quick that he left this sound. And I think it's because even though he could do it, I don't necessarily know if this is like a sound that he was really passionate about. Well, obviously, because he didn't end up doing it on any of the other albums. But it also just goes to show you that Louis Tomlinson is underrated because he does have very, like, he has a lot of variety. And people never give him credit vocally on the things he's able to do. Just because of the genres that he chooses to do now for his solo work, people don't give him credit. All those years in One Direction, all those years writing and recording and performing and touring, he's never gotten the credit that I feel like he deserves vocally. And so as we're going into this song, I just want to sit here and, like, praise the fact that he is doing a straight up, like, dance club radio pop track. So good. Like, the execution is perfect. And I think that helps with that collaboration with Steve Aoki to bring those dance beats in. But Louis is singing in a higher range than I'm really used to him doing. It all just fucking plays together so well. Hey. Oh, that rasp. And the harmony right there. Okay, that's definitely my favorite vocal moment in this track. Anytime he gets that even higher, little bit of emotion, a lot of rasp, like, that is a fucking sound that I actually wish he did more of. I know we're talking about Walls a lot, but, like, there's not a ton of songs on there for him to have those moments. So I'm hoping that he wants to pull a little bit out of his arsenal when it comes to the new album, because I know he's got the execution of this so well. Oh, yeah. Let's go. It is, there's such a good groove there. Okay, so right away, you have Louis Tomlinson all over the lyricism here. I mean, one thing that I love so much about him is the fact that he's kind of always bringing this, like, don't give up sort of mentality, and he does it in such a positive way. Oftentimes that kind of mentality can be delivered very aggressively, and while I do appreciate that, I think that's good for motivation. I just love the fact that Louis Tomlinson like addresses these things and tries to give people hope and a positive like space. And so I feel like lyrically, like even though I feel sonically like it's not something that he is probably going to do again, even though it'd be really cool to hear him do it, I feel like lyrically, this is 100% his personality. And that's so important because regardless of the, you know, the like pressure that was put onto him by the record labels or anything to make certain solid musics and all this shit, Louis still got his voice out there. And I think that's very fucking crucial because I know that, I don't know, I just feel like when I listen to him, that's one of my like things that I go back to time and time again. It's like his vocal delivery is going to be amazing and it's going to match that lyricism that he's giving us. And he writes really deep and from the heart. And again, when you have those hopeful, positive messages, like you're going to fucking be happy. Like you're going to feel like you're not alone. You're going to feel like you have someone there that is supporting you and rooting you on. So for that, fuck yes. Collaboration with Steve Aoki. I imagine that Louis was actually really fucking stoked about this. I don't know the story behind any of these things. And again, because I feel like I have this narrative that I heard that the record label was kind of like putting pressure on him, you know, it like kind of like taints what I think I said the word taint. It kind of taints the image that I kind of think about how this kind of went on. So maybe if you guys know the story, you could tell me in the comment section. But I imagine that because Louis Tomlinson is, you know, a huge fan of music, like above all else, it'd be so cool to collaborate with Steve Aoki. Like Steve Aoki's done some really great stuff. Another thing that I think is really great is the fact that this song has a stylistic sound that was so popular at this time. Oh my God. I remember driving to work in my Dodge Challenger. If I forgot like an iPhone cord or something and I had to listen to the regular radio, this is what all of the pop songs sounded like at that time. And I was a big fan because they used a lot of vocal work as instrumentals, just like taking a lyric or a melody or something and looping it back into the instrumental. It was like a really popular thing around this time. So I feel like when Louis is coming out, and I'm pretty sure this was one of his first tracks out of One Direction, correct me if I'm wrong, I feel like when you're taking that step out into that solo career, it's kind of hard because no matter what you want to do, I think there is a level of pressure from everyone around you, from fans, from expectations you put on yourself, expectations you feel like other people have put on you to do something that's popular at that time, to kind of like go with the flow of what you're already doing. And this song nailed it. 44 million streams, by the way, at the time of recording this. So this song accomplished that. And I think with Steve Aoki in it, it really helps because he was able to nail that instrumental that is so popular and was so popular at this time. Louis Tomlinson did something pretty amazing here, showing up vocally for a style that I had not heard him do in a very long time. Because even if you think about the early One Direction tracks, I'm like running out of breath because I'm fucking stoked. Even when you think about the early One Direction tracks, I always think about like they were definitely pop, but there was always that element of like rock kind of in there somewhere. And obviously we learned that with the later albums. So for him to come into this like dance track, like fucking we're dancing. We're having a great fucking time in the club. Something I've not really been to before, but we're having a great time in the club. And Louis Tomlinson nailing it vocally. I think he's actually like overperforming for what the song even needed with this instrumental. And that says a lot about his character and like who he is. But you hear that rasp, you hear that emotion coming out, something that you don't always get in some of these like club songs. You'll get something that's like super catchy, upbeat, makes you want to sing, but you don't always get that connection to the lyricism. And I feel like it just goes to show that Louis can literally dive into a different genre. And as long as he's delivering the same kind of lyricism that we've grown to expect from him with the vocal range that he has, we're going to like feel connected. We're going to take away more than just dancing. You know what I mean? Like even in this song, even if things get tough, even if things suck, don't give up. Just hold on. Things do get better. Having that kind of hopeful message in this, like being able to walk away from a dance track inspired, is fucking exactly what I expect from him. So again, I think he vocally outdid the song for what it really needed to just be a radio pop hit. You didn't have to do all that. But to have it the way he did, it just goes to show that no matter what style he's going into, he's going to be him. And I think that authentic self that he has is one of the things that have always like had me drawn so close to him. That and the fact that he exists. At one point, him and I have probably shared oxygen somewhere. And the fact that those molecules are going out there and I'm somehow physically connected to Louis Tomlinson based on breathing just goes to show that like anything is possible. But in all seriousness, this guy doesn't get enough credit vocally. For the styles that he doesn't get enough credit vocally. If you disagree with me, just go listen to Walls again. Like, listen to Walls and then listen to the music that he's influenced by that had him create Walls, and you'll see what I'm saying. Like, he is a very strong vocalist, and with those styles, like, it's just fucking, oh my god, he brings out some of the best moments in that. I'm nerding out at this point. I feel like I just ran a marathon because I'm fucking so excited. But I just feel like people need to give Louis Tomlinson the fucking love that I think he has earned and deserved. Watching Away From Home Festival, just the documentary part on Patreon, I have seen the level of work, talent, ambition, drive, motivation, all the things that he does and puts in when it comes to a live performance, when it comes to his music, when it comes to training with a vocal coach. Like, the amount of work he puts in, like, none of us, like, if I was working on that level, I'd have even more success. And I feel like having that kind of inspiration around, I'm ranting. I just fucking love talking about the dude. And anytime I get a chance, okay, whatever. I love you guys. Huge shout out to Ryan over on Patreon for requesting this. Thank you so much. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Sorry if I ranted a lot, but I got a lot to say when it comes to Louis often. And I feel like sometimes I don't always get to talk about him that much on YouTube. So I'm glad to see that we got to do that today. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this track and my breakdown on just kind of like, actually not even my breakdown. Just let me know if that's true that the record label was like putting pressure on him. I love you guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.